Hi everyone, welcome back. Thank you for being here and tuning in. Today we have a very special guest, which I'm excited about. She is from Ukraine, which originally I'm from there as well. I moved to America when I was 7, so it's really cool to have a person from Ukraine, and her name is Alesia. She is gonna teach using acrylics this beautiful water scene. And if you'd like to see more of her artwork and her, you know, channel and see what she's up to, check out the link down below. I'll link it. Everything she's using, I'll also link them down below for you guys. All right, guys, thank you for being here. I hope you'll enjoy the lesson. And if you do recreate this, please be sure to use hashtag ColorByFeliks so that we can see it and share it with our community. Have fun, guys, and see you next time.
Hello from Ukraine, everyone. I'm Alesia Khabovich, and today we'll go together through all steps required to paint a realistic ocean wave with acrylic paints. I've took 3 acrylic paints, indigo, ultramarine and phthalo blue. I use thick brush for applying the initial layer. Palette knife is also good for that purpose, so you may use it instead of brush. I'm mixing paints to make the color of ocean depths. I add just a little bit of water, and I'm starting my acrylic painting of an ocean wave. That's great that you are here, and I'm show you how to paint splash step by step. It's really hot today and acrylics needs more water. You may also use paint thinner. It helps a lot to make different effects while your paint stays smooth. But today I won't add it because it's not essential and will focus on materials that we can find in every beginner artist studio. You may see that paint has to be smooth enough but still heavy. I'm just getting rid of white canvas. You may also do it fast. The middle of canvas I left on purpose. I will make another color for this part of the painting, and it will contrast to this dark blue. Don't forget to add water for a better result. You see huge amount of sky blue light and a little bit of phthalo blue and ultramarine. I'm taking a smaller brush comparing to the first one. I'm just changing color of canvas to be suitable for me. Maybe you've already tried to use different color canvas. I like them very much. You just choose hue that you need and it's great. I'm blending colors in the bottom of the wave. After you finish the ground layer, just let it dry. You may use hair dryer or leave your work for some time. I want to notice that this time depends on how it is sunny and hot in your studio. Acrylic paints are sensitive to temperature in the room. I'm painting just near a sunny window. You may see colors of paints on my palette: titanium white, indigo, ultramarine, phthalo green, burnt umber, permanent red and draw sienna. All these brush strokes are still approximate and rough, because now I'm just making general sketch of future painting. You may take smaller brushes to apply pre-image of future shadow foam parts. By the way, you need to make several shadow foam colors, mix of titanium white, indigo and permanent red. More titanium white help you to make more light color, indigo more dark, permanent red more violet. Combine them and you'll make volume parts of foam. Now I'm applying the lighter part of the shadow. This is the base of the future drawing. This entire layer will be painted over, but it is very important for adjustment, changes, clarifications. It will only slightly show through the subsequent layers. I add more titanium white to make more light parts. This is my foam palette. Phthalo green helped me to make perfect color for main body of water. Now I will make the most light color of whole painting. I'm mixing titanium white and teeny tiny amount of burnt umber. I'm applying this mix on canvas where will be the brightest places. I don't need this for composition, just for reference to compare with other colors, to understand what color range to choose in the future. Blend in some previous strokes. To make the wave more expressive and voluminous, I've added a little bit of sienna to turquoise and titanium white. Sometimes an admixture of a different color helps to highlight and express the existing shades. The smooth brush strokes brighten up the composition in the background. Don't forget about other parts of the painting. One touch of your brush and it helps you to keep in mind whole composition. Now it is very important moment. Please make mix of greenish blue, raw sienna and white. You may also add burnt umber or indigo to make it more dark. And apply it on the bottom of the wave. My experience tells me that colors of your painting will differ from mine. Even in a teaching class, all students have similar but in that unique works. And form again. Long and thin brush number one helps me to paint form. I'm blending some parts. adding foam, don't forget about mix of indigo, permanent red and titanium white. Use at the same time different brushes with different paints. It's the easiest way to specify some moments. For example, now I'm showing the direction of the wave movement. I'm applying mix of titanium white, turquoise and celestial blue. That's where foam flows to the surface, where water splashes creates foam. For surely it's not white, it has its own color. You may show these parts of painting by mix of titanium white, turquoise and celestial blue. Add in some light. Detailing. White, turquoise, permanent red, permanent yellow, burnt umber, ultramarine, sky blue light, celestial light, dollar green, indentranium blue, indigo. Celestial blue with a tiny amount of dollar green and titanium white continue to show waves volume. Applying light blue, almost white, on the upper part of the wave, so our inner shadow become more clear and expressive. You may show how water flows down. Apply celestial blue right on the dark foam. Add a little bit lighter color of foam too. This number 6 brush has interesting jagged shape. It is slanted. These features let you make at the same time several lines, or one when you push on the paintbrush strong enough. Applying light accents. Changing color of foam, it becomes lighter. Light watercolor. You can make blending with dry or wet brush. you may do your composition applying celestial blue with a watercolor and mix of light and dark foam. Top of the vase should be highlighted with sky blue light color. I've also added phthalo green and white. After applying flows of foam and water stream, I'm blending these strokes. Applying light foam for understanding of color range. Just spots of light. I'm not painting this foam on purpose, because I want to show you how to deal with it in two ways in the end of the painting. You may see this mess, and I really want to show for those who just start to paint that there is no reason to be afraid of such a mess and mistakes. I know that beginners, even afraid of white canvas, afraid to start and to make mistakes. Surely you will do them for the first time, but it's okay. You should learn how to go your way, your own art road. For those who are afraid white canvas, I will tell about one simple trick. Just think about this canvas as a gift to you, some kind of present to express your emotions. Let them flow. It may become your meditation. Helpful long brush. blending. Turquoise, permanent yellow, ultramarine, indigo, white, dull green, permanent red, burnt umber. Refine strokes and blending. Applying different shades of foam. Some celestial blue with a little bit of ultramarine. In this way, you show how water appears in foam parts. We are painting shadow of the wave, but the light is still breaking through. Foam has its structure. It is made of bubbles. You can sharpen contrast, blend with dark and light colors. You may choose several parts of the wave where foam is seizing under the surface. And mix of white, permanent red and indigo. I am choosing titanium white because it is opaque. Think white is more transparent. Transparent colors are more suitable for glazing than opaque ones. When you're making transparent layers one by one, you should use more water or paint thinner for acrylics. For oils, you may use mediums, which liquefies the color whilst giving it more transparency. No water, of course, when we say about oils. I'm starting to work with my 0 and 2 0s brushes. They are excellent for details. You may see a mix of shadow and light. And celestial blue again. Blending. Shadow for some small parts. You may see that painting after blending looks not so expressive, but it is needed for creation really nice highlights. Work with foam. Don't use the brightest colors for this part of the painting, because it is in the shadow. Please look at this dark foam near to the brightest color of the painting. Beautiful and natural contrast. Greenish blue helps to make impression that in all these flying drops and splashes reflects shadow part of the water surface. Mix of greenish blue and burnt umber are for those parts where we get rid of foam at all. In this way we may see bottom of the wave just right here, although the transparent water. This mix of paints we slightly apply near the dark foam. Medium shadow color. Take dark color of water to show shadow from the foam. Detailing. Add in some splashes. And smaller ones. Foam on the top of the wave, but it has light shadow foam color. More light we will add a little bit later. Here it is. New foam highlights. And a new splash. You may see the contrast on the background. This light reveals volume of the floating foam. Lines of bright foam create sunny mood. Water appears through the foam. Now I'm starting to paint the most catchy part of my ocean wave painting. I will come back here many times, but it is the moment when I'm making the basis of it. Shadow to express the contrast. Add some light and shadow. Detailing. I'm adding reflection of celestial blue on the shadow part. Add in light. On my palette are ultramarine, titanium white, turquoise, phthalic green, indigo, burnt umber, rose sienna, permanent red. I'm continuing painting with a mix of titanium white, ultramarine, and permanent red. Don't forget to add water. Use this mix for bright foam details. Detailing and blending. Use 1 or 0 round brush for the smallest details, and number 2 flat as additional. Here it is, mix of turquoise and celestial blue. I've added more celestial for variety of colors. I'm trying to avoid one color for big areas, using gradient or combining them in a suitable way. Showing light on the background. It is still called color, white with indigo. Now it is time for one mix of white and burnt umber. Applying turquoise and indigo mix. some light again. I don't forget about other parts of the painting, making more detail. I'm highlighting lighter areas and areas of shadow in the foam. Areas of flowing water begin to appear in the painting. Here is the color of light foam again. I'm coming back time after time to the different part of the painting. I use almost the same colors, but with due detailing, blending, highlighting. And with every new layer, the work becomes more interesting. Lighten up some foam shadow again. This light we see in the shadow area comes from above through the water. You may see how different stroke of the thin and long brush. You may have a practice somewhere on your palette or on a paper for acrylics, how to make long lines or something similar to the shape of hooks or various short strokes. General lines, trying to make composition. Foam can't be the same in all parts of the painting. Nature likes variety. Just above the peak of the wave, I place the concentration of foam. In some part of the painting, there is much smaller amount of it. Thank you. create variety of strokes. Use mix of turquoise and sky blue light. Every time I'm coming back to work on details of previous parts of the painting, I see new possibilities to make my artwork better as I understand it. My teacher at the university said that you need to return to your work in a few days after finishing. It will help you get an impartial view on it and significantly improve in a short time. I treat my paintings the same way. I try to come back after a while for the final completion. It often happens that everything becomes very clear in an instant. What to add, what to save, and some good moments I just try not to spoil, don't touch. Continue to add light colors. Now you see the principle of work, how we move from darker colors to lighter colors and change accents. We're just making more details, more rectification. combining cold white and warm white. Titanium white and burnt umber. I'm reminding about this mix, this warm white, and this use to the color palette of this work. light strokes. Wave movement always has its own clear direction, so I'm trying to show it. Among white and burnt umber, I have ultramarine indigo and permanent red. I'm going to use at the same time four brushes, number 4, 2, 1 and 2 zeros, mixing white, indigo and permanent red. Brush number 1, foam detailing. I'm adding more white and ultramarine. Thank you. turquoise and indigo. I'm checking if it is enough water in paint. Working on the foam in the right corner. foam splashes. They may be round or no, but there are lots of them. They are flying, moving, and falling down. I've decided to add even more bright color than white and burnt umber, white and raw sienna. It is made to highlight highlights. and as an opposite one of the darkest color detailing. As you can see, some details for the foam. Bright splashes everywhere. This area we may see very good. It is very close, so I want to make it look realistic. Blending. foamed water, light blue but not white. Light parts of the shadow. Continue to paint foam. Its direction may say about how close water is or how the flow goes. I'm trying to make the whole composition ready. I emphasize the wave with dark color above it. Thank you. add some light to this water. Add dark color of water. For this time I use turquoise and indigo. Use the same color for the bottom of the wave. And for shading, Add in some dabs. Detailing. Is it finished? The signature is put and the picture is ready? No. Now I will finally make the foreground more accurate and demonstrate how to make a reflection on the water. White, indigo, dollar green, permanent red, and sky blue light. I'm making mix for a foam, white, permanent red and indigo. Some time ago, I promised you to show two ways how to make this foam more neat, and that is the moment. For the first way, you make four colors. Two for the foam, cold and warm, and two for the water, dark and light. My opaque titanium white in the mix of the colors makes foam to look dense. Color of water making beautiful contrast to the foam. I'm covering previous layers step by step. You may see the process on the video. You may see on my palette mix of indigo, phthalo green and white. Use foam and water palette to make it look great. I'm mixing dark foam color, indigo, permanent red and white. I left one part without significant changes to show you the second way of final touches for acrylic painting. In this way you may completely finish your painting. But I want you to show one more way, how to finish it with oils, just in a few minutes. All canvases for oil painting has its basic acrylic layer, so you may use your acrylic painting as a basis for your oil painting. And the good news is that you don't have to cover it completely with oils. You may take advantages of acrylics and oils at the same time. How to make it? You have to take medium for oil paints, and in this case, white, ultramarine, indigo, phthalo green and phthalo blue. So when you understand that you have finished with acrylics, because you can't apply acrylics after oils, you take medium for oils and brushes. I have to warn you that it's better to have separate brushes for oils. At first, new brush have to be wet with oil for oil paints. And you know that there are different kinds of brushes. Some are better for oils and others for acrylics. So now everything is ready for painting. Don't forget that you can't mix water and oils. And you may enjoy how smooth and soft and pliable oils are. They dry not so fast as acrylics, but you can choose medium that help them dry faster. So, I wish you good luck with your ocean wave painting. Thank you for being here with me. Bye-bye.